Hello friends, welcome to Learner's Planet. Friends, in this session I am taking some of the queries from quant and reasoning sections. I suggest you to have your paper and pen with you. Just see the problem, pause the session, try it on your own, then match your answer and solution with mine. Right? So let's take the first one. Now let's take this question. There are 4 to 5 questions based on this information. The questions are based on Venn diagrams. We have discussed good number of problems based on Venn diagram in basic Venn diagram sessions. You must attend all the sessions before you come for the doubt solving sessions, right? Then only you'll be able to attend the problems. Okay. Here, in a school of 3000 students, the ratio of girls to boys is 7:8. Girls, boys, 7:8. 7 plus 8, 15, and it is 200 times of that. So it's 1400 and 1600, right? All the students study 3 different subjects, Hindi, English, and Sanskrit. I draw the Venn diagrams for both girls and boys. This is Hindi, English, Sanskrit for girls. This is Hindi, English, Sanskrit for boys. Okay, once you complete the Venn diagram, then all the problems can be solved instantly. Now, Hindi, English and Sanskrit. 30% of the boys study only English. 30% of the boys, that means 480 boys study only English. That means only English is which region? This region. Right, that we have already discussed in our basic session. So 480 will go over here. Right, this is done. 2/7 of the girls study only English and Hindi. Only English and Hindi girl. 2/7, that means 400. 2/7 of 1400, that is 400. Right, so they study English and Hindi. Only English and Hindi will be this portion. This portion, right? So that's 400. Okay, so that's also done. Then 1/8 of the boys study only English and Sanskrit. 1/8 means 200. They study only English and Sanskrit. So English and Sanskrit, only English and Sanskrit will be this portion. So that's 200. Okay, number of girls studying only English is 85% of the boys studying the same. Now only English and boys is 480, so 0.85 of 480 will be only English in girls. So 0.85 of 480, that's 408, so that's only girls, only English, right? Then 2/5 of the boys study only Hindi and Sanskrit. 250, that means 40%. 40% of 1600, 640. They study only Hindi and Sanskrit. Hindi and Sanskrit. 40% of 1600, that is 640. This figure is 640. Okay. So that's also done. 40% of the girls study only Hindi. 40% of 1400 is 560, so that's only Hindi. So this is 560. Okay, so that's also done. The remaining girls study only Hindi and Sanskrit. Now we have to add up these data. 5 and 4, 9, 9 plus 4, 13. 1368. So out of 1400, 1368, if we subtract, we'll be getting 32. 32 is only Hindi and Sanskrit. So Hindi and Sanskrit only, that's 32, right? This is 32. Okay, so that's clear. The status of the girl is clear. Girls is clear. The number of boys studying only English and Hindi is 10% of the girls studying the same. Only English and Hindi is girls 400 and boys must be 10% of that. So that's 40, right? The remaining boys study only Hindi. Now this is 200. 6 and 2, 8 and 4, 12, 40, 40, 12, 80 plus 80, 1360, right? So out of 1600, if we deduct 1360, 240 will be there and they study only Hindi. So that's 240. Right? Now the entire status is clear over here. The Venn diagrams are complete. Now you can answer all the questions. I just take up one of the question. Here, number of boys studying only Hindi is what percent of the girls studying only Hindi? So, number of boys studying only Hindi is 240. Number of girls studying only English, only Hindi is 560. So, we have to calculate this percent. Now, this is what 3 by 7. If in a fraction, if we talk about, say 1 by 7 is 14%, so 3 by 7 will be around 42 point something, or we can say around 43%. Okay, now depends upon the option how much approximation is required, that you have to see while doing the questions, right? So all the questions will be like this only. There will be 4 to 5 questions based on this passage. So once you draw the Venn diagram, after that all the questions will be very easy to answer. I hope you are clear with the method. Now, this question from simple interest. A certain sum of money laid on simple interest for a period of 2 years at a certain rate. If same amount were laid at 3% more rate of interest, it would have fetched rupees 156 more. What was the amount? See, 3% is 156. The difference in rate is what? 3%. So, and that is equal to 156. That means 3% is 156. So, 100% will be what? 5200. So that's the principle. So pretty simple problem, not much paperwork is required. Even this calculation you can do mentally. Okay. Now this one. There are two groups A and B in an organization. Group A has 3 times more members as in group B. The average salary of group A is 36,000 and average salary of group B is 42,000. Then what is the average salary of all the employees? So this problem can be easily solved by allegation method. Group A, group B, right? Number of members is in the ratio 3:1. Group A has 3 times. So the ratio is 3:1. Now, average salary of group A is 36,000. Average salary of group B is 42,000. I assume overall average is X. Right now this X must be lying somewhere in between 36 and 42, but it should be smaller than 42 and obviously greater than 36. So I will write this over here and 42 minus X over here. Right now this and this, they are in the ratio 3:1, right? So I equate it by 3. So 42 minus X is equal to 3X minus 108. Okay, so if we calculate, 4x is equal to 150, so x is equal to 150 by 4. So that's 37,500. This is 36,000, this is 42,000, so it is 37,500. Alternatively, what you can do, see 36 and 42, the difference between these two, the other way around, the difference between these two is 6. Right now what you do, divide 6 in the ratio 3:1. So that's 1.5 and 4.5. Right now just add this 1.5 to this 36, you'll be getting overall average, because this is 3 times and this is like this is 3 times than this. That means the average will be closer to this. Okay, so closer to 36, that is 1.5. So 36 plus 1.5, 37.5 will be the overall average. Okay, so this way also you can go, and by allegation method also you can go very easily. Okay, precisely what we are doing over here, see 36 and 42, right? We distributed 6 in the ratio 3:1, that's 1.5 and 4.5. Now, average should be lying between these two, obviously. So, what you can do, either you can deduct this to get the average or add this to this to get the average, right? In 36, you will be adding this, and from 42, you will be deducting this to get the average, okay? So, either way, you can go. Conceptually, you should be clear about it, okay? You'll be getting same answer in both the cases. 42 minus 4.5, that is also 37.5, and 36 plus 1.5, that is also 37.5. So either way you can go, but you should be conceptually clear. Okay. Now friends, here I'm having a problem based on setting arrangement. Here two criteria are given, arrangement of setting as well as choice of color. Okay, so we have to take both the things into consideration, and we have to find out the right combination of people and color and their sitting places. Okay, now there are 8 friends and there are 8 colors. These friends are sitting in 2 circles, one inner circle and one outer circle. The members sitting in outer circle are P, Q, R, S, that's fixed, and all of them are facing towards the center while the other are facing away from the center. Now see, there are choice of colors as well as setting arrangement, right? So we'll be making 2 diagrams over here. One is this circle. Okay, I draw it neatly. Wait a moment. Now this is the setting arrangement and this is metric for colors. See, definitely problems based on puzzles are a bit time taking, but if 4 to 5 questions are there, then this time is worth spending. Right, so here there are 4 persons sitting inside the circle and 4 persons outside the circle, right? So this is the situation, and I write the colors over here. It's red, yellow, blue, green, orange, black, white and purple, right? And here P, or I just take A, B, C, D, P, Q, R, S. A, B, C, D inside the inner circle and P, Q, R, S outer circle. Okay, now let's take information and just fill up them in the tables and circles, table and circles, one by one. Now D likes neither yellow nor white. So D likes, this is D likes neither yellow nor white, and faces R. I suppose B is here and R is here, right? So that's clear. Who likes neither black nor purple? That means R doesn't like black or purple. So R, black, cross, purple, cross. Now this sentence is over. Then the person who likes orange faces the person who likes red. So orange and red, they face each other. That means one of them is in the outer circle and other of them is in the inner circle. Then only they can face each other. So we keep it pending. A, who likes green? That means A likes green. So we tick A as green. Then all their remaining crosses, don't forget to make the crosses. Okay, faces the immediate neighbor of the person who likes blue. Now we cannot find out the sitting position of A, but A is facing a person who is neighbor of blue, right? That means A is in the outer, if A is in the inner circle, obviously the person with blue is in outer circle. That means blue is not liked by A, B, C and D, obviously. So blue, I cancel blue for B, for C and for D, right? Blue is blue will be choice of either of P, Q, R and S. Okay, so this is the information that we can find from this. R sits second to the left of S. Now R sits second to the left of S, that means R and S are on opposite corner. Okay, so that's clear. The person who likes white and red are in separate circles. Okay, so white and red are also in the separate circle, that means orange and white are in the same circle. Okay, the person who likes black sits on the immediate left of S. So immediate left of S, here the person is there, he is liking black color, right? That means black is in the outer circle, right? That means B, A, B, C, D are cancelled for black. So A is already cancelled, B, C and D, they are also cancelled for black. Now next is Q, who does not like blue, does not face A. That means Q is also not liking blue. So I cancel blue for Q also. This is blue and this is Q. Okay. Now this is important. The person who likes black and purple are immediate neighbors, and one of them faces B, who likes yellow. That means B like yellow. This is the one information. Then black and purple are, B is in a inner circle. Then if one of them is facing B, that means both of them are in outer circle. That means black and purple are cancelled for A, B, C, D, all of them, right? So I just put up the crosses, and B is liking yellow, that also we mark over there. So B is yellow, all other are cancelled. Okay, then black and purple are in outer circle. So black we have already crossed for inner circle. Now purple is also crossed for inner circle. Okay. The person who likes orange and green sit in the same circle, but they are not immediate neighbors. Now we already know A likes green. That means green is actually inside circle, inner circle. That means orange is also in inner circle, right? So I mark orange and cross for PQRS, PQRS, right? So orange is now in inner circle. Apart from that, orange was facing red and white was also facing red, right? Now orange and white, they are in same circle. That means even white is in the inner circle. So I cross white for PQRS, okay? PQRS. Now see here, the person who likes black and purple are immediate neighbors, and one of them faces B, who likes yellow. So see here, black and purple should be immediate neighbors. So either R should be purple or S should be purple, right? But one of them is facing B, right? But R is already facing P, that means R doesn't like purple, S likes purple. So S likes purple and he is facing B, and B likes yellow color. Okay. Now since we got to know S likes purple, so I mark purple for S. So I cancel for everybody else. Apart from that, orange and white that we have found out that they are in inner circle. That means red, orange and white, they are facing red. That means both of them are in opposite circles. That means R should be in outer circle. So I cross R for A, B, C, D, right? So this way. Now if you see D, there is only one box empty over here. That means D and orange is the right combination, right? That means orange is not liked by C. Then for C and white, that is a right combination. Okay. Now we refer the data once again to make the setting arrangement complete. Now we got to know maximum of the colors liked by the people. The person who likes orange faces the person who likes red. Now we got to know that D likes orange. That means D is liking the person who is who likes red color. So D is facing the person who is liking red color. That means R, red, right? So R and red, that is the right combination. So all other are cancelled for red. Okay. Now you can see for Q only this is empty, that is black. And this black is cancelled for P. That means P is left for blue. Now we got to know all the colors of all the persons. Now we just have to crack the setting arrangement. See, black is liked by Q, that means Q is over here. Now R here, Q here, S here, that means P must be here. P is here, and we'll know the color that P likes, that's blue. Now only 2% are left, A and C. Now see here, A who likes green faces the immediate neighbor of the person who likes blue. Now here P likes blue, that means A faces immediate neighbor. That means I have made a mistake over there, because earlier we got to know that the persons who likes black and purple are immediate neighbors and one of them faces P who likes yellow. That means one of them. So it is not necessary that purple and yellow are facing each other. Maybe black and yellow are facing each other. Okay. So in that case, B must be here and A must be here. Right. Now A, B and this must be C. Right. Now the entire story is clear. The arrangement of ABCD, arrangement of PQRS, their color likings and everything is now clear. You can very well verify this. And whatever the time this is taking to make this arrangement, that will be distributed among the questions, right? If there are 4 to 5 questions, so that's pretty good. You can answer all the questions instantly, okay? I hope all your doubts are clear now. So in the next session, I'll be coming up with more concepts, more doubts. If you have, just send me on alka@learnersplanet.com, okay? So see you in the next session once again. Bye-bye.